Welcome to the Appian Function series. The videos in this series provide practical examples to guide you in working with common Appian functions. In this first video, you'll learn what Appian functions are and how you can use them in expressions to perform powerful tasks in your applications. Appian is a low-code platform, so you'll build most of your applications using point-and-click configuration and drag-and-drop components. For example, you can build complete interfaces by simply dragging and dropping components from the palette. In some instances, you'll also want to fine-tune the behavior of specific objects in your application. This is where Appian expressions and functions come in. An expression is a statement composed of literal values, operators, functions, and variables that is then evaluated to produce a result. Appian functions are pre-built blocks of reusable code that can be used in expressions to execute specific operations with ease. They accept input values known as parameters and then generate an output. Functions are versatile and powerful and serve unique purposes. There are functions to perform calculations like returning the sum of specified numbers or to convert data from one type to another. You can use them to format data in interfaces, determine how to route data in a workflow, or to set visibility logic for certain components. Since functions contain pre-built logic, you just need to identify one that meets your needs. You can find a complete list of all Appian functions organized by category on the Appian documentation page. Click on a specific function to find a description, usage considerations, and examples. If there is not a pre-built function that directly meets your needs, you can use multiple functions together and store that expression as an expression rule. Expression rules are essentially custom functions that can then be called from other expressions. There are a few ways to add a function to an expression. Within the expression editor, you can click the toolbar icon to view and select functions that are grouped by category. You can also type FUN or function to see a list of all available functions. If you know which function you need, you can type the function's name directly and select the auto suggestion when it appears. If you place the cursor inside the parentheses, the documentation pane at the bottom will explain the purpose of the function as well as its parameters and their expected data types. Now let's take a look at an example. Acme Auto wants to build a form for adding new vehicles to their fleet. On this form, they have a field where users enter the added on date for the vehicle. They want to add a read-only field for the next maintenance date, which will automatically populate with a date 6 months from the added on date. This can be done using a function. Although this function is used in the interface, I'll show you how to configure it in an expression rule for easier testing. To start, we'll use the abang addDateTime function. For this function, the parameters are the start date time and the increments of time you would like to add to it. We need to pass in values, or arguments, to return the output needed for our interface. For the start date time, we'll put the created on or added on date. As for the increments of time, we'll set months to 6 and the rest to 0. When you test this function, you can see that the return date time value is 6 months from the added on date. You can see that the date changes dynamically on the form as well. You can use functions on their own, or you can combine them to achieve more complex behaviors. In the add vehicle form, there is a file upload component for uploading vehicle images. Acme Auto wants to add a validation to the component so that users cannot submit an image larger than 5 megabytes. For this validation, we'll use an expression with two functions, if and or. Before we see how they work together here, let's take a look at them individually. First, the OR function returns true if any inputs are true, and returns false if all of the inputs are false. The IF function checks a condition to see if it is true or false, and then returns the first value if the condition is true, and the second if the condition is false. In our example, if any of the uploaded files are larger than 5 megabytes, a validation message appears. If the output is false, in other words, no uploaded files are larger than 5 megabytes, then no message appears. You can see this in action when we try to upload a large image that exceeds 5 megabytes. As seen in these examples, you can use functions and expressions to perform specific operations. There are different kinds of functions for different purposes. And lastly, functions are like building blocks. They can be used on their own or combined together. If you wish to learn more, check out the rest of this playlist to find videos on commonly used Appian functions. For more info on specific functions, visit Appian documentation. And to stay on top of our function series, please like this video, subscribe, and hit the notification bell to see more videos like this one. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.